In this video, we will discuss an example class of very common entanglement distillation protocols which operate on two entangled copies and aim at extracting a single more entangled copy. We will then also consider a specific distillation procedure from this class used to deal with a very particular type of errors. The procedures that we will consider here include a controlled NOT gate, which has already been discussed before. This quantum gate is very analogous to its classical counterpart. In the classical scenario, depending on the value of the first bit, the second bit is flipped or not. That is, if the first bit is zero, the second bit value remains untouched, as can be seen on the top two circuits. If the first bit is one, the second bit value gets flipped, as can be seen on the bottom two circuits. Now, in the quantum case, our first controlling bit can be in superposition of 0 and 1, in which case in superposition we flip and don't flip the second bit. This effectively allows us to correlate the two qubits, which in other words transfers certain information about the first qubit to the second one. This correlating property will be crucial in our distillation procedure. The general setup of the procedure is as follows. We have Alice and Bob, whose labs are depicted with the black squares. They share two entangled pairs depicted by the two horizontal lines. The source pair is the one whose entanglement we will be trying to increase using the second target copy. We also know that the corresponding operations of Alice and Bob will be depicted such that time flows to the left in Alice's lab and to the right in Bob's lab. In the first step, both Alice and Bob perform local CNOT gates, as shown on the slide. The CNOTs effectively correlate the two copies. Next, Alice and Bob measure the two qubits of the target copy locally. Because the target and the source copy are correlated, by collapsing the correlations of the target copy, they effectively project the source copy in different states, depending on the outcomes of their measurements. Finally, they use a classical communication channel to compare these classical outcomes. For outcome configuration in which the source pair becomes projected into a more entangled state, the source pair is kept. It is discarded if the configuration of outcomes of Alice and Bob doesn't match the success condition, as in that case the measurements have actually decreased the entanglement in the source pair. Let us now consider a very specific distillation example for a very specific type of noise in the system. In particular, let us assume that Alice and Bob want to generate the state phi plus, as shown on the slide. Unfortunately, from time to time an error occurs, in which case Alice and Bob unknowingly share the state psi, which is an unentangled product state that is orthogonal to the desired maximally entangled state phi plus. Let us now go through the distillation procedure on the two copies of such a state as described before. Let us firstly consider the case in which both copies of the state are actually the desired phi plus state. Then, Alice and Bob apply locally their CNOT gates so that the CNOTs are performed from qubit A1 to A2 and from B1 to B2. You can check yourself that in this case the total state remains unaffected. Let us now look at the case where the second target copy has an error. In this case, the CNOTs transform the two copies as shown. Similarly, we can obtain the corresponding result if the source copy has an error and if both copies have an error. You can now pause the video to verify these calculations. The final part of the distillation is the measurement of the target qubits A2 and B2. Let us look here for which cases the qubits A2 and B2 can both give Alice and Bob outcome 1. In the first case, Alice and Bob apply their measurement to the state phi plus. Hence, with probability 50%, they measure the desired 1-1, and with 50% probability, they measure 0-0. In the second case, it is never possible to obtain 1-1, neither in the third nor in the fourth. Hence, If Alice and Bob keep the source state on registers A1, B1 only if the target copy was measured to be 1-1, they are guaranteed to extract the perfect maximally entangled state. Of course, we see that there are plenty of possibilities to obtain different outcomes on the target copies. All those non-1-1 cases which classify as failure, and in those cases both copies will be discarded. This was an example scenario in which with finite probability a perfect maximally entangled state could be extracted just from two copies of the noisy state. In most cases, however, the noise that arises in the experiment cannot be completely eliminated when performing distillation only on two input copies. Yeah.